So have you ever wondered if each formation in Football Manager has a direct counter? You know how rock beats scissors but paper beats rock, that sort of thing? Well, after our recent video talking about the recipe for winning the Champions League in FM24, we did a deep dive into one of our own tips, where we pointed out that you could add columns into practically every data tab of this game, and if you insert columns into the schedule tabs, you can add in and view yours and your opponent's used formations for any completed matches. And what's even more remarkable is that you can use this on your opponent's schedule tab too, to see what formations they may have been fielding, as well as perhaps formations they might have struggled against this season. Now, this is a particularly handy tip when you're up against a team you're not quite sure how to one-up, and we've experienced firsthand a dramatic turnaround or two as a result of adopting an opponent's bogey formation mid-match. So does this mean that it might be possible to create a cheat sheet for countering opposing formations based on results observed in every team in the league's schedule? Well, in this video, we're going to give it a go and find out. As always, it's all timestamped, so maybe skip forward if you're watching this at a wedding whilst you're on the toilet and it's nearly time to wipe. Off we go. So let us begin with a bit of scene setting then. We are balls deep in a Marseille save in FM24, and whilst we finally managed to catch up with PSG and we've started bagging domestic trophies galore, we're struggling to get past the quarters and semi-finals of the Champions League. So we're using this formation trick to get the best of our otherwise unknown opponents. We think it's had a dramatic impact, but truth be told, there are a lot of other factors in play here, such as how strong our squad is getting, and also the home and away advantage. However, after our Champions League recipe video, we thought we'd reflect on a few seasons worth of results in Ligue 1 and see if patterns emerge from other combinations of formations, and to see if we could isolate the strongest formation in FM24. Now, the beauty of this game is that you can essentially import any view you like into Microsoft Excel for a little extra analysis, if the data hub hasn't got everything you're after to start off. Now, Squirrel Plays is the account to follow if this is your cup of tea. He's got some insanely cool videos harnessing the power of Python, and we strongly recommend checking him out if it's the analytical side of FM that floats your boat. So you can see we don't have every match for every club scouted here, and despite my best efforts, this couldn't be improved upon, unfortunately, even after trying to add a manager to every club. But we think we've still captured enough to base a conclusion on. And once we had imported, trimmed, reformatted, enriched, and filtered our dataset, it was time to look at some results. Now, we initially thought of breaking down results by each club's league position, or a bucket thereby, as we suspect that there's a significant bias in which formations come out on top and where squads were the stronger. But looking into it, we saw enough of a balance actually across the leagues, with clubs like Nice and PSG adopting two or three formations over the course of the season. So here comes the fun bit then, and this hand-cranked Sankey diagram shows the win percentage for each of the five most common formations adopted, and there are a few things that jump out at me right off the bat. Firstly then, fuck me, 5-2-1-2 looks strong. It has pissed all over 4-4-2 and 4-4-3, and has won half of its games against 4-2-3-1 and itself. It's also one of only two formations to register wins against 80% of the formations faced. I should add at this point that I didn't include my own formation in this mix, as I'm rocking a very customised Gegenpress, which ironically only struggles against 4-4-2. I'll show you what I think is the most overpowered formation though, later on in this very video. So what else can we observe from this Sankey then? Okay, let's first acknowledge though that this is a cool visual, right? I hope I'm not alone in thinking that, and I also hope that even if this doesn't give you enough to base a formation change around, it's at least provoking a new way of thinking about how you assess your team's performance. FM Immortal is all about those thought experiments, baby. Okay, back to the actual analysis then. So 4-3-3 only registered wins against 4-2-3-1, as did 4-4-2, in fact. And the win percentages for 4-2-3-1 are not amazing. Certainly, they didn't win more games than they did, if you catch my drift. So don't let the number of lines emanating from the purple box confuse you here. Now, 5-3-2 is an interesting one. Again, of the observed games, that is, the matches which our scouts were able to record down both formations used, we only witnessed draws. There were three matches, actually, and there was a draw in every one of them. You'd think that this might be because a defensive formation like 5-3-2 nullifies attacks and results in more boar draws, but there was a 3-3 in that mix, so that's a bit debunked. My major conclusions here, though, are that 5 at the back is definitely hard to beat. 4-2-3-1 may not be the master key to winning in FM anymore, as it has been for so many seasons on end, but ultimately, this test is not as conclusive as it could be. If we could scout every single game and get those results into our Excel file, we would be a lot more statistically significant in what we're presenting. As well, factoring out home team bias and factoring in league position would strengthen our resolve. But if you want a more evidence-based approach to these things, there is literally a guy called Evidence-Based Football Manager, and he too is worth a follow. So let's get into what I believe is actually the most OP formation in FM24 then, shall we? I think I've played close to 15 seasons on the game now, and a few permutations thereof, the kind of 5 at the back, the 4 at the back, and what I'm about to show you has led me down this path. Now, it certainly does rely on a certain key role being filled by the right player, but this is my domestic treble-winning Marseille side from year 9 of my FM24 save. So, up front, we've got big Jovan Milosevic. He's the best player you've never heard of, available at the start of FM for under 10 mil, and last season he bagged me 57 goals across all competitions. For those of you who saw this video where we spoke about the importance of jumping reach, you'll know that we actually lost him for a season to Chelsea in an end of contract deal, but I'm delighted to say that we sold our soul to the devil and brought him back a year later, and goodness me, was he worth every single penny. So an advanced forward with 17 or higher jumping reach is your spearhead to this otherwise Christmas tree looking mess. Two advanced playmakers behind him, which is a little bit unusual. They have got running wide with ball and sitting wide otherwise as an instruction. And I'd like to try a support striker in one of these roles, but ultimately they are a lot harder to come by in the shape of wonder kids in FM24 than an advanced playmaker would be. And Simon Roger Zola, who's got one of the best names I've ever discovered, and company, they are much easier to interchange in an AP role as well. So I can really mix it up here by having four players that play in either of these two positions. The tricky bit then is nailing down the two DM roles, and for seasons upon seasons I played with two CMs instead, but the goals conceded from the edge of the penalty area when you have no DM in this game are extraordinary, so you do need to have a DM there in my opinion. Now, when I say a decent wingback is essential, I mean it, and we probably have the best three left wingbacks in the game. And a few seasons ago, we even broke the bank to bring in the best right wingback wonder kid of all time, this chap named Almeida. Look at those attributes. He cost us a cool 100 mil, but on the flanks, these wingbacks give us everything we need in attacking width. Two wide centre-backs then, either side of a ball-playing defender's stopper, and a goalkeeper on defence behind them completes my custom 5-2-2-1, and for me, this exploits all the right attacking channels, allowing the wingbacks to cater to Milosevic with crosses from deep and enabling those two advanced playmakers to otherwise drag the defence in all sorts of directions, whilst our deep-lying playmaker arrives late to add edge of the box pressure. It's honestly a super strong setup if you've got the clientele. You don't miss the wingers and you'll score headers aplenty. Just look at the results in this XG table. Now, looking at where we have struggled over the last two seasons then, bringing this video full circle and back to that formation trick we started with, the one thing that our formation tends to struggle with is two up top. I think that's because two tiki-taka playing 1-2 passes can easily dissect three players who don't know who to pick up. So I think we've struggled against the likes of 4-4-2 and 5-3-2, ironically. That kind of goes against the Sankey diagram I showed you, but we did strip our team out. So I've been tempted in these matches against those 4-4-2s to revert to a 4-1-2-2-1 sort of elongated diamond, and I find that this pays dividends in keeping away tactical familiarity whilst giving me the edge against teams I'd otherwise struggle with. But what do you think is the best way to counter opposition formations in FM24? Do you have a go-to technique for nullifying certain setups? Let us know down in the comments, and until next time, my friends, adios.